Hi everyone, in this session we will discuss about IPC. What is IPC? Inter-process communication. So here in this we will start discussing about pipes. What is a pipe? A pipe is nothing but a pipe is a communication medium between two or more related or interrelated processes. Okay, what is a pipe? A pipe is nothing but it's a communication medium between two or more related or interrelated processes. It can be either within one process or a communication between a child and the parent process. Okay, so if you see the rough sketch of a pipe, see here. So if any descriptor, if you want to write any data into the pipe, so that can be done from this end. Okay, if you perform any write operation. Similarly, if you want to perform any read operation, that can be done here. So here we have defined the read operation with this descriptor, pipe descriptor 0, pipe DS 0. So the write operation is done with this, pipe DES 1. Okay, so pipe descriptor 0 is for reading and 1 is for writing. Okay, so next, so we are going to describe the same. So what we are going to do is, so descriptor pipe DES 0. It is for reading, whereas one is for writing. We already discussed that. Okay. And whatever is written into pipe descriptor 1 can be read from descriptor 0. Okay. Whatever whatever the data we have written by using descriptor 1, that can be read by using descriptor 0. Okay. And it is represented with 0 if the operation is successful. If the transaction is successful, it is represented with 0. If anything goes wrong, it is represented with -1. Okay. And see here. To know the cause of failure, we have to check with this variable or this function. Okay. So this is about the description to pipes. Next, coming to shared memory. What is shared memory? So shared memory is nothing but, shared memory is a memory which is shared between two or more process. Okay, if a memory is shared between two or more process, we simply call it as, it's a shared memory. Okay, the interrelated process communication is performed using pipes or named pipes. Okay, the interrelated process communication is performed using pipes or named pipes. Okay, next, unrelated processes communication can be performed using named pipes or through popular IPC techniques of shared memory and message queues. Okay, right. So this is the figure for shared memory. Okay, process 1, process 2, different processes sharing the memory. Okay, different processes are sharing the memory, right. So, before using the shared memory, we need to execute some system calls. We will see those. Before using the shared memory, we are supposed to execute some system calls. So, we have to, the first one, create the shared memory segment or use an already created shared memory segment that is indicated with this. Okay. We have to create the shared memory segment or we have to use an already created shared memory segment by using this function. Okay, that is the first step. Coming to the second step, what we have to do is, we have to attach the process to the already created shared memory segment. Coming to the third one, what we have to do is, we have to detach the process. We have to detach the process from the already attached shared memory segment. Okay, we have to detach the process from already attached shared memory segment by using this function. Okay, and last but not least, what we have to do is, we have to control all the operations on the shared memory segment by using this function. What this function will do? It will control and coordinate all the operations in the shared memory. Okay. Next, we will move to FIFOs. Okay, so we used one pipe for one-way communication and two pipes for bidirectional communication. Okay, so here a single named pipe can be used for two-way communication. Okay, see, this is server to client and client to server. Okay, so we are discussing here about client server and server to client. So to create a named pipe, the following system call is used. Okay, so these are the system calls which are used to create a named pipe. Okay, and next. And next we are going to discuss about message queue. Okay, what's a message queue? If all the processes do not need to access the shared memory, if all the processes don't want to access the shared memory, but very few processes only need it, in that situation it would be better to implement with message queues. So when we will go for message queue, if all the process don't want to access the shared memory, but a very few process need to access it, in that situation it is good to implement with message queue. Okay, if you want to communicate with different data packets, let us say process A is sending message type 1 to process B, type 2 to process C, type 1 to process B, okay, and type 10 to process C and type 20 to process D. In this case, it is similar to implement with message queues. To simplify the given message as 1, 10, 20, it can be either 0 or positive or minus or negative. It is shown below. You can show it here. See here. The communication using message queue, it can be like this. See here, process A wants to send message to process B. Okay, similarly if you want to perform, so in the previous example what we have done, we have sent from message A, we have sent to type 1 to B, we have sent to B, we have sent to C, we have sent the message to D. So that is shown here in this figure. See, process A has sent a message to B. See, message queue 1 to B, 10 to C, 20 to D. So like that, if very few process wants to send the message, it can be done by using message queue. Okay, this is the example. See here. Okay, so next we have message queue. Okay, to perform communication using message queue, the following steps are required, or we have to follow the following steps. First step, what we have to do is, we have to create a message queue or connect to an already existing message queue by using this function. What we have to do? We have to create a message queue or we have to connect to an already existing message queue. The second step is, so now we have created a queue. Now we have to put the data into that. So now write into message queue. So we have to put the information into this queue using this operation. Okay. The third one is read from the message queue. Okay. We have to read the data from the message queue by using this operation. Okay. This function. Okay. The fourth one is perform control operations on the message queue. We have to perform control operations on the message queue using this function. Okay. Last but not least, what we are supposed to do is, now let us set the syntax and certain information on the above system calls. Okay, so that is what we are supposed to do. So with this we will wind up the IPC. Okay, inter-process communication topic we will wind up. Okay, thank you.